Hi and welcome for another video for linmob.net. This is the PinePhone and it's not my UbiPorts PinePhone, but it is my Postmarket OS Convergence Package PinePhone running Manjaro Lumiri Edition Alpha 1, which was released earlier today. Now, as the name may suggest, this is really early and I tried to make a video before and well, that's why I can't show you the first run visit here, where you just show just choose the Wi-Fi network and then you know, continue, but I think that's not necessary to see that because it's not all that interesting. This is basically an adaptation of Ubuntu Touch by UbiPorts to Manjaro, and well, it's early, but this UbiPorts in green is already running pretty well. Now, my video I shot earlier and decided not to use ran far too long, so I'm just going to start a few applications here and show you how they work. First up, Morph Browser. Morph Browser is a pretty good cute web engine based browser, which you may which you definitely know if you've ever used Ubuntu Touch. This is DuckDuckGo right here, and I will just go to my blog, which loads quite quickly. It's linmob.net, and now this is the weekly update. I wrote today there are tons of video in here, so we might just pick a short one. How about one of those by Megi, and see if the promised video acceleration actually works. Oh god, all this crap always. So there's sound, and the video is playing pretty promising here. Look at that. I think that's pretty much as good as video playback on the PinePhone currently gets. And let's just go back and go to the release notes of this first alpha of Lumiri on the Manjaro forums, which are a bit slower to load. So right here, what they did, they ported Lumiri. They have Morph Browser, which is using GPU acceleration, initial setup with that, which we are not seeing right now, but well, it's all you would expect. Initial work on calls and SMS functions are done. I will just quickly call this phone to show you that it's generally working. I will not answer the call because that would cost me money, because my landline is not a flat rate. But as you can see here, receiving calls worked, and I tested earlier that the audio also works. You will have to trust me on that. Also, while we had those key functions, which many people are interested in and keep nagging me about, even though they are really hard to demo if you want to keep your privacy, I got an email by my mobile phone provider here, and it says that I have only a small balance, less than €1 here. Unfortunately, there's a little bug with this SMS app. You have to basically scroll up and hold to read the message, but yeah, it works. You can receive them and you can send them, which is pretty cool, I think. Now, then there's another app people always care about, and that's the Contacts app. I don't have any contacts on here, but you can import contacts from SIM card. I can try that. I don't know if I have any on that SIM card. Yeah, see, I deleted them. Or from a vCards file, which is pretty good for everyone who can export their contacts elsewhere. Vcards file are common used standards. And I can create a new contact. swiping up, and then we can just add some fictitious person that is called Mob and has a phone number, and it's, well, 555. That's Devok Mobile. An email address that is, I don't know, maybe example at linmob.net. And that, of course, is the work email address. And we can also try to add a picture, but we can't choose it, apparently. Although there is an image viewer installed, yeah. So that's something that would have to be done, and I... maybe I did something wrong and it didn't add that contact now. Well, whatever. There is a contact app, and I think it could work, and if it doesn't work, they will work on it later. But there are also, as they write here, some more apps. We will have a look at some, maybe. Now, what's currently broken? Calls are highly unstable. Well, I got one working call, at least. Messaging might not work properly, but receiving works. No vibration functions yet, no camera functions yet. There isn't, is no camera app here. No auto brightness. Well, I don't think that's much of a loss, because even on the large proprietary platforms, auto brightness is often hit and miss. And then no volume buttons or volume control. Well, that's unfortunate, but at least audio works. So there's known issues. Font gap between the dollar sign and the cursor within terminal app. Let's just have a look at the terminal app. Yeah, that's true. There is a gap, and I think it's because they are using a non-monospaced font here for the terminal, and that just doesn't really work generally. So I think once they make it so that they use a monospaced font, the terminal will be fine again. UI may become unresponsive after a while or show glitches. Well, I had glitches in my earlier video, none here yet, but I'm sure I will run into some. Lots of apps are still missing or not mobile friendly yet. Now, the apps that come pre-installed are all, despite those two in the fourth row. Let's just, I mean, the calculator, that's really boring. Clocks app, well, let's have a quick look at that. Okay, so now we can maybe add an alarm. Okay, so it should ring in 3 minutes. Let's see if that works. So that's a clocks app, it's very elegant. Document viewer, which is for PDF and stuff, and I put a PDF on here of an old video I did, and yeah, that's working okay, I would say. Now what else do we have? File manager. Oh, let's look at this picture here. And let's open it in preview. And yeah, that also works. Now, what else do we have? Messaging. I demoed that already. Morph browser, you've seen it as well. And then we've got the phone app, which is your standard UReports phone app. It says it has no network, and I will not enter a number here because privacy, but entering a number generally, because I'm sure some people will not believe it otherwise, it works. Yeah. And that is one glitch, actually, that it came back weirdly there with less height. System settings, is where you can set up your Wi-Fi cellular. You can enable mobile data here, enter your APN and stuff. So there's quite some stuff you can do. Currently it doesn't seem to recognize my SIM card, although as you can see saw earlier, receiving call weirdly worked, but yeah. And then there's some other stuff in settings up, like mouse and touchpad for convergence, time and date, which should help you probably properly set your time zone, but that didn't work for me either, unfortunately. So yeah, and then there is no button or anything else to do, and stays at +0 and doesn't go to +2 where it would have to go. So there's something broken up. Obviously, language and text is where you can change the language, and there's another glitch. So that's clearly not working yet. So it seems to be English only for now. Well, what else do we have? We've got the music app. And that one always says no music found, but actually I have some music here, and I think I can even play it maybe, but yeah. So the music app doesn't work yet, which was actually really worth the testing. Now I installed one app from which is known to work from Fosh, and that is gedit or text editor, just to demo how that works on Lumiri currently. And as you can see, it looks just like it looks on the desktop, and it doesn't adjust well, and text is really tiny, the keyboard doesn't come up, and so on. So that's not good. And then let's test the Plasma Mobile Kirigami app, and that is weather, which you can install by running pacman-s kweather-git and then kirigami 2 as well. And yeah, it sort of works, but it also doesn't know the proper screen size, and this menu here is always open. You can't close it, so I think that's the desktop view of that app too. And yeah, they will need to do some more work to make use of all these applications written for the other environments, which would be really cool if they managed to do that, because then you could use them all on Lumiri, which is actually, I think, really has great multitasking, has a decent app launcher, and all the features one would want generally. So I really hope they continue their work here and are successful, so that we can have something like UbiPorts, but with easier packaging, so that it's easier to bring over new software quickly. Of course, UbiPorts, rather complicated packages, has its benefits too, for example, with regard to security. I will not get into that now. But generally, this first alpha is nice. I wouldn't recommend you to try to run it as a daily driver, if you're even attempting daily driving your Pinephone at all. And that's that. So yeah, make sure to check out my blog, and maybe also my Twitter. You can find all that stuff at the bottom of my blog here. Twitter is at linmobblog, and I'm on the Fediverse too. I'm at linmob@fosteron.org. So yeah, maybe consider following me if you care about the Pinephone and other mobile Linux platforms. And thank you so much for watching. Have a great week and stay safe. Goodbye.